Okay, here we go. We've had a full 12 hours soak in the water. See, I'm back later than I should be, so the nets are already out of the water. All the nets are intact, which is good. So we'll go along and we'll see what we've got. There as well, look at that beauty. Beautiful, that one in the back. A little ray as well, got the full back ray. Put that one in the back. Don't think that's legal size, but nice to see anyway, so I'll put that one in the back ready to go back. Sole there as well, that's it. That's legal size, that. It's over sole. Dabs around. Plenty of them. Clear the other way. Give you a better show in a minute when we get off the beach. So I just want to get them all out of that first, and then that we can have a proper look at them top end. So just want to get them out, get them all out the sun. That sun's an absolute trouble for them. Dries them out. Don't want that. But at least they've fished all right. Just shows what a difference it makes when that wind's in the west. Yeah, so like none of this, not even any little bits when that wind came round on the last video. So I mean, it just shows how important that wind is, that it comes around to the west, northwest, southwest, either of those directions are great. I'll untangle that in a minute. Place as well, that's illegal. Size a bit small, but that will go back in the water. A little baby ray here, look, baby ray. That's that little thorn back. Oh, they're right next to each other. salt. That's legal size. Flounder, that one. That's a flounder. That one's legal. I'll eat that one as well. A little baby turbot down there. Like your mother, your grandmother. Turbot. Well, that's a good place. Absolute stonk of that. That's a running place. Beautiful. Just a little god hole up for you. Look at that. Beauty. Both of these fish have come in on the ebb tide, the ebb being the tide that's going out, because you're coming to feed on the big tide, and then they head on out then. And then, so, you know, I'm across the gully as well, so this is why they've been nabbed. Across the gully and wallop, no other place to go but my net. Surprising how this net has caught these, really, because as I say, it's a 5.5 inch mesh, and these should just go straight through the net. As quick as I can to minimalise the oxygen levels of them. Thank you. oversized dab coming home. Consequences of putting nets across a gully, I guess.
All the weed, the other two I can see from here, they're crystal clear.
In the sand. Strap, you see, so just literally taking the fish out of the nets. I say, we'll have a good look in a minute when we turn on the fish, because we've got to do gutting and cleaning. Salt. Let's do the salt. Get a few more of these in the night time tonight. Twice that size. Absolutely beautiful fish last year. So they'll start to show up a bit more as the year goes on. When I put the nets out for the cod and the plaice and flounders and stuff back in the winter, I'd say I only got half a dozen flounders and a cod. It's because of that wind. But this is what these nets should fish like all the time. These nets should fish like this all the time. It's kind of a good video to see how the fishing really is on this beach. There's plenty of flatties. I wasn't going to bring my waders, but I'm glad I am now, because I'm absolutely filthy. old, sadly died. But we're all undersized anyway, so. Catch. Down there as well. Nice place. Yeah, beautiful campfire, these places, beautiful. Dover sole's so easy to get out of that. Just clear the mouth and bang and it's out. Catching flatfish, so they're living up to the name, aren't they? We'll go in the bag and come back. Live and kicking, nice to see. But, still one. Father or your grand, you're no good to me. Get you without the sun. little baby rays. They'll only go in one way, the fish, but sometimes it's best just to pull them through the mesh rather than trying to find where their heads are. There you go. That's that as well, which is nice. Coming to the end of the first net in the 75 yard each, so I've done probably only done about 60 yards. And I'll say just slightly bigger foam back ray here. Look, not keen on ray myself escape, but. Form back right there.
Still alive as well. I'll pop him in the bag.
Nice oversole down there. Say we'll get a few more soles in the nighttime tide tonight. That's when they come out to feed. So I had some beautiful soles last year. Oh, some absolute beauties.
They were good as well, they tasted really nice.
Fish the night tide tonight, and we'll fish the daytime tide tomorrow, and then we'll bring the nets in tomorrow night. So I'd say that freezer needs to be full. Filling up. A whiting, or another. Thought it had warmed up a bit too much for them.